Hey everyone, so we're gonna do a little flow here over at Pura Vida Studio, just so you guys can kind of get a taste for what it is and what the space is like. It's got good acoustic, let's say that. First to start, it's a big space everyone. I'll put up a cute little video too, but thought I'd give you guys all a chance to kind of flow at home so you can kind of get a feel for what the mornings on Sundays are gonna be set like. But yeah, excited to be here in Billings and back in studios teaching. So if anyone has any questions, please feel free to shoot me a comment or a DM on my Instagram and I can answer those for you. Some new student specials are running as well. So lots of fun things in the making. So that being said, let's go ahead and ground down through our seat. Crown of the head lifts up to the sky. Take a nice deep inhale through the nose. And exhale through the mouth. Again, nice deep in. And exhale. Let's go for two more rounds on your own. One more time, big inhale. And exhale. Soft gaze out at the floor in front of you. Always starting off our practice from a space of gratitude. Give gratitude to this earth. She reminds us that we live in a space of abundance rather than a space of scarcity. Give gratitude to the indigenous peoples of these lands. The Crow, the Cheyenne, the Salish, and the Blackfeet tribes. Give gratitude to Black and Brown people as the original creators and sustainers of this practice of yoga from a space of ahimsa, nonviolence and non-harm, or loving action. Give gratitude to our bodies and to ourselves, our own ancestors and our own lineage. And if there's a person or persons, place or places that you'd like to dedicate your practice to today, you can take the time to do so now. Nice deep inhale. And exhale. Again, big inhale. Go ahead and slowly plank them open. Since it's just y'all and me, I'll take this way. So you guys can get a good space for the practice. We got room. All right. So grounding down through your seats. Really think about axial extension. If you all can check in with Mike Massey out in Boston, he taught that. He taught me about axial extension. So from the hips down, ground and root into the earth, you can always have the option of sitting on a block as well. But we have a tendency to kind of fall into our hips. And then everything from the seat up lifts and rises high to the sky. Nice deep inhale, arms sweep. Exhale, flip the palms and press any stagnant, stale energy out and away from you. And then again, inhale, arms high. Exhale, flip. Tent the fingers beyond the hips. And then press down through the palms and just get that nice big stretch that runs from the tips of the fingers up the forearms. arms and into the shoulders. Big inhale here. Exhale, tuck your chin down towards your chest. Still trying to press down through the palms, keeping that extension through the fingertips, so the 10 through the fingers. Maybe try swallowing a couple of times here. And then inhale slowly, pick the chin up. Tilt the chin high to the sky, relax and release through the jawline. And then slowly bring the chin back down to your center. Slowly turn and look out past your left shoulder. Roll back and down through your right. Big inhale here. Exhale, hold. Two more big breaths. Big inhale. And exhale. Last one. Big inhale. Exhale slowly. Bring your chin through center line. Same thing on that opposite side. Turn and look out past that right shoulder. Big inhale. Big compression of the thyroid, then slowly tip the chin so it points to the upper corner of the room, relaxing and releasing through the front part of the jaw. And then exhale, slowly release. Keep your arms high. Hands come into prayer, they come down to your third eye, setting your intention in your mind. Right, we're in this, we're right at like that quarter mid mark of the moon between the full and the new. So thinking about what it is that we're releasing. Hands move down to our heart line. Press your thumbs up against your sternum. Sternum rises to meet your thumbs. Big inhale here. Exhale. Nice soft gaze into the fingertips. And then release. Hands come back down to your sides. Inhale, sweep that left hand up and over. Hop onto your right ear and pull that left ear down towards the top of your shoulder. Big inhale here. Exhale, hold. Two more big breaths. Big inhale. Find that stretch again from the tips of the fingers all the way up into the skull. Big inhale. Exhale, hold. One more time. Big inhale. Exhale, release. Head comes back to your center line. Same thing on that opposite side. Fingertips 10. Opposite arm sweeps up and over. Hop onto that ear and pull it down towards your shoulder. Press down through the palm. Keep the fingertips tented as much as you can. You can always extend the fingers a little bit beyond the hips. Big inhale. Exhale, hold. One more time. Big inhale. Pull up through the crown of the head and the chest. And then exhale. Head comes back to center. Grab onto your knees and then pull your chest forward. Small circles here. Pulling with your chest. Engage your low belly for four, for three, for two, and for one. And then take it back that opposite way for four, for three, for two, and for one. Bring yourself back to your center line. Inhale, arms high. Exhale, they come back down. Hands can come back behind you. You can keep yourself where you're at on the mat, but fingertips towards you. Big toes come together to touch. Press into your palms to raise up through your chest and then let your knees drop over to the right hand side as you press here. Knees and ankles can stay stacked, so getting into the hips. Stretching through the biceps, the front part of your chest, and then slowly move yourself through your center line. Same thing on that opposite side. Turn and press, big inhale here. Exhale, slowly bring yourself back to your center line. Press into your palms, keep that mini micro bend in your elbows, and throw your hips up. Reverse tabletop, big inhale here. Engage your low belly, check in with your hands, make sure your thumb is still involved in the posture. Exhale, set it back down, press into the palms again. In, up, hold here. Exhale, slowly set it down. Two more, inhale it. Exhale, down. One more time, inhale, lift. into your back. We'll do some abs right away. Get them out of the way. Feet plant to the mat. Hands come down to kind of graze the backsides of the heels, or at least reach into that space. I like to pop my chest up and roll shoulder blades underneath, and then tuck your chin so you can elongate through the spine again. Inhale, press the hips up high, holding here in a bridge pose. Exhale, slowly lower down. Inhale, lift, press, chin still tucked in towards your chest. Your low belly pulls in towards your spine, and then exhale, slowly lower. Two more. Inhale, lift and press. Exhale, slow and lower. One more time. Lift and press. Exhale, slow and lower. Release. Your hands from your sides, and then come back behind your head. Basic crunches here to start. Pulse it up for 8, 7, 6, 5. For 4, 3, 2, and 1. Hold here, big inhale. Exhale, hold. Two more big breaths. Big inhale. And exhale. One more time. Big inhale. Lift. Exhale. Slowly lower the back of the head down to the mat. Soles of the feet come high to the sky. Flex through the soles of the feet and think about wrapping your muscles around your bones. So all the way up into the crease of the hips, toes flex back towards your face, maybe do a little point and flex just to check in with a stretch to the front part of the shins as well, and then pulse up towards your toes. Keep your shoulder blades up off the mat for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Big inhale, exhale, lower, hover. Inhale high. You can always pop here if you want to. Lower and hover. We go for 8, for 7. Keep breathing. For 6, for 5, for 4, for 3. Last 2, and 1. Left hand to the outside of the right foot, right hand to the outside of the left. We go for 8, 7, 6. Shoulder blades stay off the mat for 5, for 4, for 3, for 2, and 1. Reach up to touch the toes one more time, and then exhale. Soles of the feet come down to the mat, hands come down to brush the heels again. Press your chest high, roll your shoulder blades underneath you, and then pulse the hips. For 8, 7, 6, for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Big inhale. Breathe into the belly. Exhale. Two more times. Big inhale. Exhale. Hold. One more time. Big inhale. And then exhale. Slowly release. Pull your knees up into your chest. Give yourself a nice big hug here. Exhale, release that left leg. Interlock your fingers on the front part of your right shin. Pull your right knee down towards your right armpit and lengthen through your left leg. Big inhale. Exhale. And then inhale, arms come overhead as you exchange out. And then exhale, hands come around to wrap around the front part of that left shin. Pull down through your chin and towards your chest. And then we're slowly gonna move through this. If you want more of an ab with this, take your shoulder blades up off the mat. Inhale, out, exhale in. Inhale out, exhale in. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, and then exhale. This time, you're gonna inhale out, and then exhale. Pull all the way in. Inhale out and hover. Exhale, pull in. One more time each side. Inhale up. Exhale, pull in. Again, inhale up. Exhale, pull in. Matching breath to movement. Release. Pull both knees up into your chest. And then go ahead and rock and roll on your spine a few times. Just to massage out through your back. And then you're going to bring yourself up and over. your knees and shins, however you get there, bringing yourself into your tabletop. Knees are underneath your hips, and then the wrists are underneath your shoulders. Inhale into your cap, exhale into your cap. Inhale into cap, exhale into cap. Go for two more rounds here, inhale. Exhale, one more time, inhale. Exhale, slowly release. Bring yourself back in to your table. Hands extend towards the top of the mat. Drop down through your chest. Your forehead comes down to the mat. Puppy pose, toes can stay tucked. Or you can release them and press down through the tops of the feet. Big inhale here. Exhale, hold. One more time, big inhale. And then exhale, shift yourself forward. Shoulders over your elbows. Coming into your Sphinx pose. Press here, press down through the tops of the feet. Big inhale. Big compression in the low part of the back. Maybe you take that right leg up off the mat and point the toes. And then pulse for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Lower it down, same thing on that opposite side. Left leg lifts. Find that catch in the low back. Let that right leg lay heavy to the mat and then pulse for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Big inhale. Exhale, slowly release. Then take your hands next to your sides. Elbows are close into your side body and then lift your chest. Try not to pop any higher than your belly button. Baby cobra, press down through the pelvis. Press down through the tops of the feet. Wrap your muscles around your bones. Big inhale. Breathe into the base of the belly. Exhale. Two more. Big inhale. Exhale. Last one. Big inhale. Exhale. Slowly release. Tuck the toes. Press to the knees. Five push-ups here in modified plank. We go for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Big inhale. And then exhale, take the hips back and high. Come into your first down dog of the morning. Pedal out through the feet, checking with the elbows. Nice deep inhale. Hips drive up towards that back corner of the room as you engage your quads and pull down through your heels. Big inhale here. Exhale, hold. Two more big breaths. Big inhale. Find that extension through the back side of the legs. Pull down through the heels. One more time, big inhale. And then exhale slowly. Walk your hands back to meet your feet, back of the mat. Let yourself hang heavy here and keep a bend in your knees. Maybe you shift back and forth side to side a little bit. Maybe you shake your head yes. Maybe you shake your head no. Whatever feels best. You can always take your hands to the back part of your skull as well. And just find a little bit of length here. You can take your thumbs and massage out through your temples and down into your cheeks. And then on the next inhale, hands pull up the front part of the shins. Big inhale here. Exhale, hold. Try not to grip with the toes. So pull the weight of the body into the balls of the feet to the point where you almost grip. And then let the weight shift back to the heels a little so you can redistribute it between the big toe mound, baby toe mound, and heel. Low belly stays engaged. Exhale. Bring yourself down and over. Inhale. Pull yourself all the way up to stand. Reach high to the sky. Baby back bend here. And then exhale. Pull yourself to your center line. Hands come down to your sides. Inhale, arms sweep high to the sky. Feet can be hip width distance apart or big toes can come together to touch, whatever feels best to you. Interlock your fingers and release your index fingers here. Big inhale. And then let yourself drift over to the right hand side of the room. Right armpit towards the front of the room, left hip towards the front of the room. And the strength of the arms pulls you into the posture. Big inhale. Come out onto the toe of that left foot. Exhale, hold. Maybe you lift it for four, three, two, and one. Big inhale. Exhale, bring yourself back to your center line. Pull up and out of the waist. Big inhale. And then exhale. Pull yourself over to that opposite side. Strength of the hands pulls you into the posture. Maybe you come out onto that big toe. Reach and pull here. Big inhale. Maybe you float that leg and tap it down. For four, three, two, and one. Big inhale. Find that extension. Exhale. Step it back. Inhale. Pull up and out of the waist. Look back behind you. Maybe back bend. Like you're drawing a circle with your spine rather than kicking a hose. Okay? So nice deep inhale. And always take your hands to the low part of your back. When you get here, breathe into the base of the belly. From the base of the belly, up into the chest. So big front body extension. Big inhale. Exhale, hold. One more time. Big inhale. Exhale, pull yourself all the way back up. Inhale, arms sweep high. Exhale. Come down and over the tops of the thighs. Engage your low belly to protect your sacrum. Inhale, hands to shins, flat back. Exhale, hands walk out into your plank. Nice deep inhale here. We're gonna go right knee to right elbow, left knee to left. Engage your low belly. We go for 10, 9. You can run it out faster or you can move slow for 8, 7, 6, for 5. For four, for three, last two, and one. Big inhale. Press back through the heels and shift forward. Drop down to the knees. Lower all the way down to the belly. Tops of the feet are flat. Baby cobra again. Big inhale. Let's wave it out this time. Exhale, lower. Inhale, lift. We go for four. Inhale, high. Find that fluid movement for three, last two, and last one. Inhale, high. Exhale, lower. Tuck the toes. Press to the knees. Send the hips back and high. Down dog. Pedal out through the feet. Pull up and in on the low belly. Nice deep inhale. And exhale. Check in with the elbows. Eye of the elbow turns to look away from you. Point of the elbow looks back at you. And then slowly walk your hands back to meet your feet. Back of the mat. Inhale, hands to shins, flat back. Exhale. Come down and over the tops of the thighs. And then inhale. Sweep yourself high to the sky. Exhale. Hands move down to your heart line. We're going to do the same thing again, but change up the cross of our hands as we pull ourselves over in half moons. Maybe if you did your feet hip width distance apart the first time, maybe you put them together this time or vice versa. Inhale, arms sweep high. Interlock the fingers the opposite way you did last time. Pull up and out of the waist. Squeeze from the midline, the inner part of your thighs. And pull yourself over to the left-hand side first to start. Big inhale. Find that extension here. Exhale. Try to distribute your weight equally. Left armpit towards the front of the room, right hip. Exhale, hold. One more time. Big inhale. Exhale, pull yourself back to your center. Inhale up. Exhale, over. Remember, right armpit towards the front of the room. Left hip, pull open through the heart and the chest. Exhale, let the hips sail over a little bit more. One more time, big inhale. Exhale, pull yourself back to your center line. Inhale, up and out of the waist. Exhale, look up into the butt of the palms, and then take yourself back. So find that big extension here, big inhale. Exhale, hold. Two more big breaths. Try to keep the biceps by the ears as you find that pull back. One more time. You do not have to go back very far to find some stretch and compression here. And then pull yourself back to your center. Dive down and over the tops tops of the thighs. Inhale, hands to shins, flat back. Exhale, hands come down to the mat, walk yourself back out into that plank. Nice deep inhale. Left knee to right elbow, right knee to left. We go for 8, 7, 6, for 5, for 4, for 3, last 2, and 1. Big inhale, press back through the heels, shift forward, 5 push-ups here, for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Inhale, roll over the tops of the feet and come into your forward facing dog. Hold here, big inhale. Exhale, hold. One more time, big inhale. And then exhale, roll over the big toes simultaneously. Send the hips back and high, down dog. Pedal out through the heels. Hands are wide, hips are high. Big inhale. Exhale. One more time, big inhale. Drag the hips high, grab onto the bones with the muscles in the legs, and then spot right in between your two thumbs. Tiptoe your feet up to meet your hands, or just casually walk up there. Your low belly still engaged. Inhale, hands to shins, flat back. Exhale, come down and over the tops of the thighs, and then inhale, we sweep ourselves high. Exhale, hands move down to heart line. Let's come into some sun bees, and if we've got time for it, we'll do some sun seas, but we'll end with some big stretches. So, all right, y'all. Inhale, I'm supine to the sky. Exhale, set yourself right down into your chair pose. In chair, chest moves high to the sky, low belly pulls in. Big inhale. Let's pulse it out for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Big inhale. Exhale, hold. We're gonna go low and then shoot high. So big squats, low and high for 8, 7, 6, 5. For 4, for 3, last 2, and 1. Baby pulses again for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Inhale, arms high. Exhale, bend down and over the tops of the thighs, engage your low belly. Inhale, hands to shins, flat back. Exhale, hands come down to the mat. Step, step into your plank. You're gonna take your right knee, left elbow, kick it out beyond the mat. You're on the outside edge of the foot. As you drop your back heel, fallen warrior, hand can come to the sky, or it can reach forward. Big inhale. Breathe, exhale. Two more, big inhale. Exhale, hold, one more time, big inhale, lift. Exhale, release, hand plants. Step it back. Come back into your plank, fire up through the midline. Same thing on that opposite side. Left knee, right elbow. Take the cross body, drop your heel, lift through the hips. Fingertips can come towards the front of the room. Lifting here and pressing down through the outside of the foot. Exhale, hold, one more time, big inhale. Exhale, hand plants, step it back, big inhale. Exhale, lower. Inhale, hover. And lift. Hold. Breathe into the low part of the back. Exhale, and into the base of the belly. One more time, big inhale here. And then exhale, roll over the big toes. Simultaneously, take it back to down dog. Pedal out through the feet. Nice deep inhale. Checking with the hands, checking with the elbows. Right leg, high to the sky. Big inhale here. Exhale, shift forward. Right knee, left elbow. Move it back and high. Knee to nose. pressing round and hold through the upper part of the back. Leg moves back and high. Right knee, left elbow, or right knee, right elbow. And then leg moves back and high. Spot your right thumb and step your right foot up to meet your right hand. Left toes hop out and over. Check in with your feet. Inhale. High crescent lunge. Big inhale. Check in with your hips first. We have a tendency to sway out through our spine. Keep your pelvis tucked, spine in a straight line. And then you can work to extend your back heel to straighten that leg. Big inhale. Exhale, lower. Inhale up, weight lunges for 8, 7, 6, for 5, for 4, last 3, last 2, and last 1. Baby pulses for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Inhale, arms high. Exhale, drop your back heel, warrior one. Press into the soles of the feet. Open up into your warrior two. Check in with your stance. Front knee moves towards your baby toe. Exhale. Holding here. Back foot's at that 45 degree angle. Flip your front palm, reach it forward, and then take it back. Bend in the front knee. Big inhale. Exhale, hold. One more time, big inhale. And then exhale. Bring that right hand down to the inside of your right foot. Left hand tied to the sky, or you pull it towards the front of the room. Big inhale. Exhale, hold. One more time, big inhale. Exhale, turn your torso parallel back to the mat. Pivot onto the ball of your back foot. Left hand inside of right foot, right hand comes high to the sky. Pull back through your right hip as you pull forward with your left. And then exhale, release. Hands come down to the mat, step your right foot back to meet your left. Press back through the heels, shift forward. We lower, hover, and lift. Big inhale. Exhale. Roll over the toes simultaneously. Keep the hips back and high. Pedal out through your feet. Big inhale. Exhale. Same thing on that left hand side. Y'all can stay where you're at. Just some space in the camera. Left leg. High to the sky. Big inhale. Shift forward. Left knee, right elbow. Leg moves back and high. Knee to nose. Press it round and hold. Leg moves back and high. Stay with your breath. Left knee, left elbow. Leg moves back and high. Spot your left thumb. Set your left foot up to meet your right, left hand, and right toes hop out and over. Inhale. Sweep yourself high. Press and lunge. Check in with your hips first. Check in with your pelvis. Okay. Inhale. Arms sweep high. Exhale, lower. Inhale up. Exhale, lower. We go for 8, for 7, for 6, for 5, for 4, for 3, last 2, and 1. Baby pulses. We're doing 16 of these because we didn't start off with babies. For, so let's go 16, for 15, for 14, 13, 12. 11, 10, woo, for 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Inhale, arms high. Drop your back heel. Bring yourself into your warrior two. Hold here. Stretch through the fingertips. Check in with your front knee. Big inhale. Exhale, hold. One more time, big inhale. Reach forward and then take it back. Reverse your warrior. Hand can hang at the low part of the back. It can come to the top of the thigh. Remember, draw that circle rather than kicking a hose. Big inhale. Exhale. Bring yourself down inside of your foot, right hand high to the sky. Big inhale here. Exhale, maybe pull the fingertips towards the front of the room. Exhale, turn the torso parallel to the earth. Pivot on the ball of that back foot. Hand plants, opposite hand comes to the sky. Pull back through your left hip and forward with your right. Keep your right leg and right glute engaged. Big inhale. Exhale. Hands plant. Step that left leg back to meet your right. Press back through the heels. Shift forward. Lowering and lifting. Big inhale. Breathe into the base of the belly. Roll over the big toe simultaneously. Send the hips back and high. Pedal out through the feet. Engage your quads. Pull down through your heels. Big inhale. Exhale, hold. One more time. Big inhale. And then exhale. Squat in between your two thumbs. Step, step. Feet come up to meet hands. Inhale. Hands to shins. Flat back. Hold here. Engage the quads. Relax and release through the outsides of the hips again. Exhale. Release through the low or the upper part of your glutes. Right? The low part of your sacrum. Your low belly pulls in to support you as you allow that upper part of the back to be soft. And then you slowly bring yourself down and over. And then inhale, sweep yourself right back into that chair. Pulse it out for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Inhale, high. Exhale, squat. Inhale, high. Exhale, squat for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. Last 2, and 1. Baby pulses for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Bring yourself all the way back up to stand. Shake it out. Grab some water if you need to. We'll work ourselves back down to the earth so we can have some nice long folds. A little bit of Shavasana at the end. Inhale. Top of the mats. Arms sweep high. Let's do a quick standing balancing before we take ourselves down. Tree pose. Kickstand that left heel up against your left ankle. Hold here. Exhale. Pull it up to the calf. Arms can stay extended. They can come here. They can come here. They can come here. Maybe you pull that foot up and over your knee. Or maybe you pull it to the inside of your thigh. Press the inside of the thigh into the inside of the foot. Hands to heart line. Hold here. And slowly release the foot. Knee comes hip height. That left hand comes out and you bring your hand back to catch the inside of the foot. Knees come together to touch. That right hand comes high to the sky. If you fall out of it, get back into it. Find a spot out on the floor that's not moving. So don't look at me, right? Look at something whose energy is totally unlocked, right? And then kick into your hand as you drop down to your chest, trying to keep your hips in a nice straight line as you do so. Big inhale. Hold there. As long as you can, fall out, get back into it. Staying with your breath as you kick into that hand. Big inhale. Exhale, hold. One more time. Big inhale. Exhale, kick out. Foot comes down. Shake out your standing leg. Same thing on that opposite side. Kickstand that heel up against your ankle. Knee falls out. Then maybe foot comes to the inside of your calf. And then maybe it pulls up and over the top of the knee. Foot can come above or below the knee, but never on the knee. The knee can go a lot of ways, just not lateral. So squeeze here. Hands come again to heart line, out, over. We can always come around you into reverse prayer. Big inhale. Squeeze here to open. Then exhale, release. Let your knee come to your hip height. Hand reaches out to the side. Find your footing first, right? Balance the body between big toe mound, baby toe mound, and heel. And then take the hand back to grab onto the inside of the foot. I like to take my middle finger right where the ankle and the top of the foot connect. Knees come together to touch. Left hand, head to the sky. Stay with your breath here. Remember, find something that's not moving. And then kick into the hand as you drop down through the chest. Reach here. Hold. Find that kick. Drop down through that right hip again. Big inhale. If you fall out of it, that's okay, right? Just take a moment and get back into it. Give yourself that time to breathe, to recenter. Big inhale. Exhale, kick. Try not to grip with that big toe. Press down into your big toe mound. Big inhale. And then exhale, come out. Shake out your standing leg. Nice job, y'all. Meet back at the top of the mat. Inhale, I'm sweet pie. Exhale. Come down and over the tops of the thighs. Inhale, hands to shins. Exhale. Hands come down to the mat. Step, step. Hold here. Drop down to the knees. Take yourself back into an embryo pose. Hop some feet flat to the mat. Claw your fingertips out in front of you. Your forehead is down to the mat. Big inhale. You can always stay in extended embryo, or you can take your hands back to your sides, palms face up to the sky, forehead down to the mat. Breathe here. So try to come into the full capacity of your lungs. Think about filling up around your ribcage. Big inhale. Exhale, hold. One more time, big inhale. And then exhale. Hands come to the outside of your knees. You press yourself up and come down and onto your seat. Go ahead and take your right leg long. Sole the left foot inside of your right thigh. Press and squeeze the two together. Inhale, arms high. You can always have options in this one too. You can always take your heel underneath your seat if that's an option. You can also take the heel and place it up into your hip crease and come on to your toes. That's a lot on your knee. You can raise yourself up to a block on this one too. But in Ashtanga, there's a couple of like different ways that you can option your way through it. But traditional, right? A, inhale, arms high. Exhale, down and over. Pull the crown of the head towards the top of the foot. And then tuck your chin in towards your chest. Your low belly still pulls in to protect your low back, creating that extra space for compression. Big inhale. Exhale, hold. Two more big breaths, big inhale. Exhale, hold. One more time, big inhale. And then exhale, walk yourself back up. Swap out your feet. Same thing again. Sole the foot inside of the thigh. Press. Inhale, arms high. Exhale, bring yourself down and over the top of that leg. Crown of the head pulls towards the top of the foot. Keep your chin in towards your chest. Wrap your muscles around your bones. Toes still flexed back towards your face. Low belly pulls in towards the spine. Big inhale. Exhale, hold. One more time, big inhale. And then exhale, slowly walk yourself back up. Take both of the soles of the feet wide. Press yourself up. Shift yourself forward. Lift and shift your seat. So pull your seat out from underneath you. Fingertips crawl out in front of you, and then slowly crawl yourself down and over. Relaxing and releasing, hands can plant. Allow the groin to release. You can play around with the point and the flex of the feet. Just be mindful for the back of the knee. Big inhale. Exhale, hold. Two more big breaths here, big inhale. And exhale. One more time, big inhale. And then exhale slowly, walk your hands back towards you. Then pull that right foot in towards you. You're gonna take that left foot and take it over the front part of that right knee. You can hang out here and turn and twist and look back behind. You can also step your left knee on top of your right. It's optional in terms of where you wanna go, in terms of a twist, or if you're looking to get into your hips again. So horse face posture, pull the chest down and over the tops of the thighs, relaxing and releasing through the outsides of the hips. Keep breathing here. One more time, big inhale. And then exhale, slowly pull yourself back up. Rock back on your sit bones. Change up the cross of the feet. Again, knee. Sole of the foot can come in. You can hug yourself in this way. Turn and twist, looking back behind you. You can also stack your knees. Okay, having this choice, you can work your way through it too in more of a flow and a progression. Sit up nice and tall and then bring yourself down and over the top of that thigh. Relax and release in the outside of the hip. Big inhale here. Exhale, hold. Two more big breaths, big inhale. And exhale, one more time, big inhale. And then exhale, press into the heels to lift, engage your low belly, relax and release. Take yourself all the way down and onto your back. Pull your knees up into the chest again, get yourself a nice big hug. Pull the low back down to the mat. Release that left leg down to the end of the mat and interlock your fingers on the front part of your right shin as you pull your right knee towards your right armpit. Left hand comes to the outside of the knee and then right hand comes nice and long and wide. Look out past your fingertips as you rock that right hip to stack over your left. Keep breathing here. And slowly release. Take that right leg down to the end of the mat and unlock your fingers the opposite way you did last time around the front part of your left shin. Pull your left knee towards your left armpit. Big inhale. Chin tucks in towards chest. And then exhale, hand to the outside of the knee. Let that left knee come to stack over your right. Look out past those fingertips. Big inhale. Breathe here. Exhale. Two more big breaths, big inhale. Exhale, hold, one more time, big inhale. And then exhale slowly, let yourself move through your center line. Pull both knees back into your chest, give yourself a big hug. Grab for the outsides of the feet, maybe you come into a happy baby. Shifting back and forth, side to side. And then slowly release. Let the soles of the feet come all the way down to the end of the mat. Hands come down to your sides. If there's any final posture that's calling to you, please be encouraged to take it. And allowing yourself just to come back into your breath. So coming back to that intention that you set for yourself at the beginning of class. So before class, I pulled the card Sacred Action around decisive focus. So looking at things from a swift knowing and making decisions, I think for myself personally, my mentor would always say, you know, baby, you're really fickle. Right, hard to make a decision. And I think it's even harder in today's world, right? Because we feel like there are so many choices. But a lot of it, I think, is rooted in a space of feeling worthy and understanding what it is that we deserve within our lives, in terms of the way that we want to be treated, right? The way that we choose to show up for ourselves from a space of love. And understanding how we can choose to show up for ourselves is how we choose to show up for other people. And sometimes pause and time and space is love, right? And I think that that's something that I've been just kind of focusing on over the past couple of weeks. Especially when there's energy within space between two people in relationship, right? Where when the energy isn't good for either person. And I think that sometimes we're so bent on things wanting to work that we get into this space of, you know, do you want to be right or do you want to be free? And so I continue to come back to that in these past couple of weeks. So, card for us to take with us as we leave. And head into our week. So the number 21, and guide the illuminated path. And y'all, this is from the Priestess of Light Oracle deck by Sandra Ann Taylor and Kimberly Weber. The Priestess guide on this card illuminates the path ahead with her right hand, which is the hand of action, right? It's our yang energy, it's our more masculine, or let's say our solar energy. And on her left, the side of receiving, right? Our moon or lunar energy. The wolf offers her guidance as well. This card is about our personal path, encouraging a deeper awareness of the choices coming up in our life. The wolf is a symbol of strength and freedom, and this is the core of the message on this card. We are free to create the path that lies before us, and we have the strength to see it through no matter which one we may take. It's time to seek the wisdom of our own inner guide. Time to meditate and ask if a new or different direction regarding business, family, or personal matters is called for. And then muster up the courage and the self-trust to take the necessary steps forward. This card could indicate the coming of a new teacher into your life. It may be someone who advises you in specific personal areas, such as education, nutrition, or finance. Or it could be someone who pursues a more spiritual path. Let yourself be open to the guidance and inspiration such new teachers can bring, together with the wisdom of your inner voice. You will find the path you are becoming illuminated, and you will be ready to take your next steps with clarity and purpose. Your eternal life deserves. Affirmation. I direct my own destiny in every way. I open myself to the loving guidance I receive from others, from the universe, and from within. Take a nice deep inhale. Exhale. I Breathe in big, inhale. And exhale. When you're ready, you can slowly press yourself up and into a simple seat. Hands can come to your heart, or they can rest down on your knees. The divine light, the divine feminine, the divine masculine, and the divine love in me honors and reflects the divine light, the divine feminine, the divine masculine, and the divine love in each of you, the collectively in all of us. Thank you all for sharing your practice with me, for trusting me with your bodies, hearts, spirits, and souls. To that, as I go in peace, and remember to serve love always. Thanks so much, everyone. Hope to see y'all real soon.